Well, as far as the women's doubles draw was concerned, six seeds left in by quarterfinal stage, six different nations, but three Korean pairs at quarterfinal stage. That was whittled down to two because two of the Korean players came through to the semi-finals, but Dwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnapa in their second consecutive semi-final once again beaten at the semi-final stage. So the only European representatives on finals day here at the Saeed Modi Grand Prix Gold in Lucknow in India. Selena Peak and Afia Muskins. Well, the number one seeds being beaten yesterday by the number three seeds. And there they are, Selena Peak and Afia Muskins. So Vaishali Udahe from India conducting the toss of the coin, the umpire for this one. So as far as the Koreans are concerned, the number two seeds, that's Jung Kyung Ung, the 25-year-old from Masan. Number six in the world ranking at the moment, this pair, and it's the seventh week that they're at a career high of six. This their third Grand Prix Gold final together. They won in Macau last year, and they were beaten finalists at their home event, the Korean Grand Prix Gold in Jeonju. So her partner is Shin Sung Chan from Kochang County in North Jeollo Province, southwest of South Korea. And she is a two-time former world junior champion with Lee Soo-hee. So they've beaten seeded pairs in both the quarterfinal and the semi-final. Number five seeds Matsuo and Naito in the quarterfinal. Number six seeds Dwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnapa yesterday in the semi. So as far as the pair from the Netherlands are concerned, that is Afia Muskins, the 26-year-old from Hawley in South Netherlands. Lives now in Arnhem, and she and her partner up one place in the world ranking this week to number eight, but they have been as high as seven just for 1 week at the end of November last year. There, Selena Peak, 24 years of age, from Blaricum in North Holland. And what a sensational victory they had yesterday. The Dutch pair beating the number one seeds in the world number five ranked pair, Chang Ye Na and Lee Soo-hee. 21-17, 21-8. They absolutely destroyed them. So this, as you saw, the first beating between these two pairs. So the players just about ready. What an occasion for this Dutch pair. Well, they have actually won a super Grand Prix Gold tournament before. That was back in 2013, the Bitburger Grand Prix Gold. In fact, they were one of only three European women's doubles pairs to ever win a Grand Prix Gold title. European pairs have won five Grand Prix Gold women's doubles titles, but only three different pairs have achieved that. Well, if you were with us yesterday, you would have enjoyed the Koreans' match against the home players, Dwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnapa. That's a good rally. Well, after their semi-final yesterday, the Dutch pair, they happened to see their coach, Kim Nielsen, and he was just so happy and so proud of his players. He said that their concentration level and their focus level throughout the entirety of the match was the best that he had ever seen, and that is always high praise from a coach. They're both very nice people. I had a long chat to them both when they were at the Super Series finals in Dubai at the end of last year. Yeah, that's lovely variation on the attacking play from Selena Peake. Slices this one, looks for angle, and very good awareness as to smash down the forehand side. Saw out of the corner of her eye that Ophir Merskens had come forward to the net and totally committed. There was no way she could have got to the back of the court. Managed to get the shuttle past her and deep. That's good racket skills. The disguise on the drop shot there from Chin Sung Chan. Look at that. Last moment. Just dropped the wrist and therefore played the drop shot. again, Luskin's encroaching in forward on into court, and that costing them dear. Yeah, it was before that. That was the issue. Super block. Look at that. Four straight points for the Koreans. Take that, five straight points. Kyung Won, Korean coach. Oh my goodness, that was a loose serve. Crikey. Got away with it. That's amazing. Seven straight points. Gone long. Yeah. Well, the one comes to an end, but seven straight points. And it'll take a lot of catching up to do. It's a healthy lead, isn't it? And only 8 minutes of play. And they look in very positive mood. The Koreans back out on court. Kim Nielsen. Trying to perhaps change the tactics.
11-4. Play.
Ah! Oh, that's great reading. Oh my goodness, I thought that hit her. Well, that's extraordinary. Played it behind the back. So that is extraordinary. I thought the shuttle actually touched the player before she played it back from the racket. Oh my goodness, well, difficult to tell. Service fault is called on Efia Muskins. When I looked at the lineup for today's finals, I thought about the possibility of, as with last week, all five titles going to players from five different nations. But with Sung Ji Hyun having already won the women's singles, and certainly at the moment, the Korean women's doubles pair of Jung and Shin looking pretty comfortable. And the likelihood of five titles going to the players from five different nations, it doesn't look all that promising right now. But the Dutch pair, they're good fighters. That's a good smash, perfect placement of the smash. From the Dutch pair, and at some stage they've got to get themselves into a position where they can attack and they can win the point. I don't think against their opposition of today they can rely on them just making errors. Oh my word, what a shot from Shin Sung Chan. Well, she's playing a blinder in the final so far. Look at that. You won't see better than that. Good return of serve. Exactly what I was alluding to. You've got to find some winners, and the winners most likely will come from attacking play. Well, that's called in. Wow. make your own minds up. From Selina Peake. Blocked and moved forward. It's nicely done, that's how you convert defensive play into attacking play. Number one seeds from Korea yesterday. The Dutch pair will know that they have the capabilities of winning this. That is unbelievable. A defensive shot from Muskins. What a net exchange. And the final shot seemed to sit on the top of the tape for an age before it decided to go over. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Return of serve. Well, the Dutch pair are certainly playing themselves back into form. Maybe a little bit nervous right at the start of the match, I'm not sure. I thought it was going out. Oh, that is delightful. Lovely skills from both pairs. And how wonderful to see both pairs trying to convert defensive play into attacking play with lovely blocks and drives. But it is game point opportunities, six of them.
Service over. 15.
No, that's service 20. Error. She was struggling with her low serve earlier. Jump in then. Second opportunity is converted. 21-15. Opening game. An opening game delighting the Korean fans here in Lucknow. 20 minutes for that opening game. 21-15 in favour of Jung Kyung Ung and Shin Sang Chan. Coach working abroad, Nielsen. Well, it was very noticeable that Jung Kyung Ung and Shin Sang Chan, only a brief word from their coach and then they were back out on the court long before their opponents. Dutch pairing, their coach Kim Nielsen, using all of his allotted time to speak to the players, and the players still in discussion about the tactics. Called on the flick serve. They're beginning to look for that cross-court block from Muskins. The Korean pair, we've seen it too many times, they're looking for it.
One.
Well, Dutch pair have been playing together since the Dutch International in April of 2013. So not far off 3 years. But even though they know each other very well and very established in their partnership, still getting a little confused. He goes for the one down the centre. Well, one suspects that the accuracy of the smash was just so perfect that it leaves that indecision in their opponents. Well, that was six straight points. And now comes to an end. And the Dutch pair get the score moving again. Attack, not all power attack, vary the pace of the attack and desperately try and get the net player involved. Because I don't see them making winners from anywhere else other than from the front area of the court. Of the mid-court area from Jung Kyung Un. Psychologically for the Dutch pairing, it was such a huge result for them yesterday, beating the number one seeds, and they perhaps weren't expecting that victory and therefore hadn't really prepared themselves mentally for the final. Of course they would have been delighted to be in the final. To believe. I know from seeing them play in many other tournaments that they've got the capabilities, but at the moment the Korean pair really are looking extremely sharp. A shot from Selina Peak. And the execution, yeah, it was just too loose. So, 11-5 the advantage here in the second game. It was 11-4 in the first game. Once again, Lee Kyung-won, not a lot of advice, just keep doing what you're doing, you're playing very well. Girls is probably what she said.
20 seconds, 20 seconds, thank you. Coach, thank you coach.
positive return of serve. Well, we didn't see it, but I can tell you that Zheng Jianlong just practicing that low serve again. She is struggling with it. Gave each other the thumbs up there. Korean players. Yeah, they are looking impressive, aren't they? Oh yes, and that's the varied angled attack, and moving forward. Yeah, well played, Afia Muskis. Look to be closing in on their second Grand Prix gold title.
Service over. Nine.
Won in Macau at the end of last year. Good serve.
10, 15.
Down the line. Been so good in all departments of the game today, the Koreans. Good attacking play, good defence, and work at the front of the court has been superb. saw the gap. And Shin Sung Chan just precision block into the open space. Look at that, that is delightful. That's long. And just 2 points away from a second Grand Prix gold title. Great vision today as Shin Sung Chan spotted where the gaps are and placed the shuttle there quite beautifully. Match point opportunities. Match point was squandered. Return of serve and another title for the Koreans Jung Kyung Un and Shin Sung Chan. A second Grand Prix gold title and a fourth title in total to go with the Denmark Super Series of last year and that Macau Grand Prix gold and the US Grand Prix as well. So 21-15, 21-13. The margin of victory there. Yes, the serve just too loose and got what it deserved.
finalists are Efke Maaskens, Shalina Peek, Netherlands. The gold medalist and Syed Modi International Badminton Championships women doubles champions are Jang Kyun Yeon, Shin Seong Chan, Korea. May I now request Mrs. Rona Chadda, Wave Group, as well as Dr. Akhilesh Das Gupta, President BAI, to present the medals. Akhilesh Das Gupta, President, Badminton Association of India, to present the chair. Once again, let's congratulate the medalists of the Syed Modi International Badminton Championships 2016 for the women doubles.